Hi, Queens, it's Vivian, and welcome to Fairy Bottle Round 4, featuring two new cute sets here. The previous three Fairy Bottle events has also returned. You can access them by clicking at this corner right here, and then clicking this next button. Here are the two Winter Girls. These have returned. And then here is the Wine Boy and the Sakura Girl. These returned as well. And then the original Fairy Bottle Girls. You will not be getting free attempts for these old suits. You will only be getting free attempts for the new suits, which is what I will be focusing on today. I'm going to show you how to get all perfect scores in this new Fairy Bottle event. If you appreciate guides like this, like and subscribe, because a lot of trial and error went into this guide. Also, please share this video with your guildmates, friends, or anyone else who will be participating in this event. This is a challenging event, and I don't want you to spend more diamonds than you're already spending. So how does this event work? First up, you pick the suit that you want first, whether it's the pink one or the green one. The suit you pick is going to be your cheaper suit, which is 1,722 diamonds. Even both of them, that is 3,294 diamonds. Then you are brought into a new event map, and for each of these stages you are given two themes, like theme number one, theme number two. You pick one outfit to use for both of these themes, and your score must be within 10k range of each other. I know that's a lot and it's difficult, but I have answers for you. So this is stage one. Pay attention. For stage one, you are going to wear this red Bean Kiss hair and Garden Tour yellow dress. That's it. For skills, I recommend bringing these skills, the Smile Critical and the Critical Block and the Sleep. I do not recommend wearing socks or shoes because the opponent can take that away and that will mess up your score. All right, let's go duke it out against my opponent. Okay, that jerk guy hit me. I was put to sleep. I'm just getting hit by everything. So I'm doing this to lower the opponent's score. Ouch, that didn't really matter because that was a zero anyway. All right, 36k. This is probably going to be an A or something, but we're not done yet. Here's another round. Let me actually block the critical eye, which is coming next. There you go. And then I want to put her to sleep. Score is pretty low, so I'm using critical eye to lower her score. Okay. Hold up right here. 42k. Look at these two score. The range needs to be within 10k from each other. They're doing the calculations right now, and boom, there it is. For being a 10k range of each other, you are going to get this whatever this thing is. This is higher than the S score, and when you get this Rubik's Cube thing, you are going to get 10 event currencies, which is the maximum you can get. Up next, stage two. For stage two, here are the two themes, and this is what I ended up wearing. I got this waving veil, and I got Mori Girl and Reindeer. Hopefully everyone has these. If you don't, what are you doing with your life? These are like super easy to get. And same skills as before. Let us duke it out against the opponent. I blocked that critical eye. Yeah, I should be blocking it. Earlier, I was just nervous and then I missed. Let's put her to sleep so that she don't hurt me that much. Let me use this Peaky Immune too, in case she uses a critical eye, then I will be able to block it. Okay, so 3999999996. And then round two is coming. And okay, let me block her critical eye. Perfect. Let me use a critical eye on her. And then let me put her to sleep. How's my score so far? Oh, that's big points for Lively. Okay. Stop right there. 41k. Perfect. Because these two is 10k points range of each other, and they're doing calculations now. And yep, here it is. Here is the Rubik's Cube, and that is the maximum 10 event currencies. Moving on to stage 3. Pay attention to this one. Stage 3 is the hardest of all of the stages because instead of being 10k point range, it is 5k point range. This is actually the only stage that I messed up in. So I ended up wearing these two items. Her Beauty hair and a Starlight Melody of Purple. I think this is a stage where you really have to utilize your skills. Okay, so let's give it a try. Okay, that did nothing. I was put to sleep right there. And I want to try to put her to sleep too. And let me just lower her score for fun, but that won't really do anything. And okay, 39K. Now I'm gonna try to get my second score as close to here as possible. Let me block the critical eye. There you go. Let me lower her score. And let me put her to sleep. Maybe you smile. Wait. Don't need to, don't need to, don't need to, don't need to. Yes! Perfect. Okay. 36K. And is this within a 5K range? Totally. And for getting that 5K range, it is going to be Rubik's Cube, which is a maximum 10 event currencies. Moving on to stage 4. Stage 4, it's back to the 10K point range, so not as bad as the previous round. I ended up wearing apple pie hair and a starry dress. Let's duke it out. So let's go. Let me just block whatever critical eye thing. There it is. Wouldn't matter because I got a zero anyway. Oh my gosh, I'm losing! I'm losing! I'm losing! Oh, this is not good! This is not good! Let me just use this critical eye one more time. Oh, okay. All right, up next is the. Oh, okay, I totally missed that. Let me use the critical eye and let me put her to sleep. And okay, let me picky immune. And oh dear, that's okay, that's fine. That is within a 10K range. Yeah, so that's what was this, a B and a C or whatever? That's okay because you combined that is still within 10K range. Heck yeah. And last but not least, it is a stage 5. Stage 5 is actually a really chill stage because the point range difference is 15K. It leaves a lot of room for error. What I ended up wearing is a little lion hair and a beach dress. Let's get to it. And okay, let's block the critical eye from her, and I want to lower her score too. And then let's put her to sleep. And yeah, that's it, I think. So right now this is 33K. All right. And then let's go round two. Remember, 15K point range. Oh gosh, I got hit by that critical. Don't matter anyway. Let's do that to block whatever. Ooh, a big points were pure. And okay, there goes the simple. And I got hit with that. Let me smile. Let me smile. Let me smile. Oh. Wait. That's fine. I didn't need to smile. I still got it. So an A and a B or a C, whatever that is. And yep, 15K range. A lot of room for error. And now it is time to gem. You can gem in any of these stages that you got the Rubik's Cube in. If you got an S in those stages, do not gem because that is not maximum event currencies. So let's do this plus 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 plus. Remember, it's a 3,294 diamonds for the cheapest cost for above suits. Let's spend that. And okay, let the carpal tunnel begin. After you're done with all that, click on this button right here. This is where you're going to claim your rewards. All right, so oh gosh, I forgot. There's going to be a lot of lore here, which I will just speed run through this over here. I picked the green suit as my first suit, so yeah, I just got the necklace thing, and then up next is going to be the gloves, and then it's going to be more TLDR. Okay, it's going to be the lime boots, and then it's going to be this. Oh, wait, this is such a unique item. I always thought this lime was a part of the dress, but it's not. Hey, that's cool. All right, so this is a lime hat. Oh, how lime visor. That's so cute. And then I have a lime umbrella, curly straw, a crazy straw thing. Where's the skip button for this, yo? All right, it's going to be this. Oh. Do I see an XD face? That is so cute. And then the makeup! Oh my gosh, what a happy makeup! It's going to be a long, curly, blonde hair. And okay, it's going to be a. Is that a dress? I think that is a dress. That do not look like a separate top. I think that's a dress, yeah. Done! And I think, what's that, a background item? Oh, it's the thing she's standing on. 13 out of 13 a suit completed for Lime. And then once you have completed this suit, you can actually get like a little boost, I guess, 2K event currencies, and that's going to help towards the next suit. Now for my second suit, I am gonna claim first. Okay, I got a crazy straw? Is that a crazy? Wait, what? Oh, it's at her mouth. Oh, that's an interesting piece of item. I think it's a crazy straw. And then it's going to be the gloves, yellow socks, and then it's going to be the. These are interesting looking shoes. I would not buy these. And then up next is going to be Coke bottle, I think. Up next, it's going to be a duffel bag with a bunny inside. Next item is going to be, oh, a bunny helmet. You know what this sort of reminds me of? Ever heard of the anime Tiger and Bunny? Yeah, that's what it reminds me of. And then we have French fries. Wait, what does that look like? French fries? Wait, where do they even go? Huh? And then we have this white hair with the yellow strand. And then up next, ooh, the makeup. Oh, what a cute face. Oh, love it. And then I think that is a dress. And then at the way end, it is going to be after the story ends. It is boom, the huge background item, and that is the 13 out of 13 suit completed. Oh gosh, this video is getting long. I'm actually going to show you a suit breakdown in a future video, if that's okay with you guys. Let me know in the comments below if it's not. And I also need to go to sleep. Okay, so what am I gonna get here? Back for my troubles. Special pose hair. Ooh, special pose dress. Oh, special pose dress, I think, without the umbrella. More limon and 30 diamonds back for our troubles. And then I have here a special pose hair, a special pose dress, 30 diamonds back for our troubles. Woo! All right, everyone, that is all for me. Thank you so much for watching. Love you guys so much. Subscribe, I'll delete your love Nikki account. Peace, peace.